Hello friends, welcome back to the online classes. Today I'm going to take lesson number 4, Healthy Eating Habits Revision. Now we know that if we need to have a healthy body, then we must have healthy eating habits. And here in the start of the chapter itself, a proverb is given, health is wealth. So if we are healthy, then we can earn a lot of money as well as a lot of respect. So we should have a proper way of eating. Now some children in a hurry to have their food do not even wash their hands before meals. There's a problem with every child. Usually not even, I don't say only for the children, but also the elders, sometimes they also in a hurry, they forget to wash their hands properly. Sometimes they just go, even the children simply go in front of the tap, open the tap and show their hand and come back. They don't wash it properly. It should be washed properly. Otherwise, what will happen? The germs may not go away from your hands. It will remain there. And when you eat it, it will go straight into your mouth and a lot of diseases can be affected to your body. So, first thing, whenever you eat, you should wash your hands properly. And now these days, since this COVID-19 pandemic time, it is always told whether you, even if when you ring up to someone, the message is there that we must wash our hands properly with the hand wash as well as sanitize our hand. So see how much it is important to wash our hands regularly and most importantly before eating the food. It is also advisable not to keep long nails on the hands as dirt may gather under them. The second thing, many of us are having long nails. We either we forget to cut the nails or some of us may be growing it as per the fashion. And it is there with the girls mostly because they like to have long nails so that they can color it, nail polish it. Now you see that when your nails are grown up, there between them, the dirt collects, and if you don't wash it properly and you eat it, so that nail from the dirt from within the nail get inside our mouth. Many people have got the habit of nail biting. So instead of cutting the nails, they bite the nails. And what happens? While biting the nails, the dirt which is there, that goes inside the mouth. And again, we fall sick. Different types of illnesses comes into our body and we are sick for many days. The germs and all get inside the body. Some people, particularly children, have the habit of eating all the time. Now, the natural time of eating or the natural time that is set for eating is morning breakfast, afternoon lunch and night dinner. These are the three times. But still, we people have added one more time, that is 4 o'clock tea time, that is refreshment time. Okay, 4 o'clock tea time. Now, these are the four main times when we must eat the food. The timing is there. Now, when we eat every time, that is after every 1 hour or half hour or 2 hours, what happens that our stomach doesn't digest the things properly. Because what we had eaten in the morning breakfast, it takes time to digest, say about 4 hours. 5 hours before the lunch. So by meanwhile the water we had eaten during the breakfast, that is digested, and the stomach also gets some rest. Okay, so after taking rest, by the time it is lunch time, so we have our lunch. So once again the stomach starts its work, just like a machine. We cannot switch on a machine for 24 hours. If we do so, what will happen? It will create problem. Okay, it won't work later on. Something similar is our stomach. The stomach cannot work all the time, and if it works also, then we get a lot of other problems in our stomach, stomach upset sometimes. The other organs are affected because of overeating. So we must not eat every time whenever we feel like, or whenever we see something good in the house kept, we just take it and eat. It should not be that way. Eating between meals may result in loss of appetite, indigestion, tiredness and laziness. So these are the problems if we eat between the meals. Between the meals we should not eat, otherwise we will have this type of problems, loss of appetite. We may not feel hungry afterwards when it is time of lunch. We may not feel hungry, or when it is a time of dinner, we may not feel hungry. One thing. Second thing, indigestion. The food may not digest properly, so that problem. Tiredness we feel, drowsiness we feel, laziness. When we eat every time and sit, then we will not feel like to work. We become lazy because we have eaten, our body is heavy. So we won't be faster, we may not like to do any work. So it becomes laziness. Some children have the habit of eating so much at a time that they can hardly breathe. Yeah, that is another problem. Sometimes mother cooks such a tasty dish that we try to finish it on the spot. And what happens? We just fill our stomach, even though the limit of our stomach is over. So what happens? The body bulges out, the stomach bulges out. We suffer with a lot of other diseases. You just imagine if a balloon is blown out of its limit, what will happen? It will burst. Stomach is also such kind of balloon. Of course, it may not burst, but what happens? There are the organs are affected because of overeating. It is a fact that many children eat their food quickly. Another thing, we should not eat quickly the food. Sometimes when we eat food, we suddenly remember, in the TV, that movie is coming, or in the TV, that cartoon show is going to start, and there is no much time, I should finish it fast. And while eating faster, sometimes our throat gets choked and we start coughing very hard, and whatever we have eaten, it's come out in the form of vomiting. And we very bad about it. We it gets in the nostrils and all, and we are difficult, we find difficult in breathing and all. So we should not eat fast, we should eat it slowly. Then some children drink little water or no water after food. And this is another thing, that we should not eat, or we should not drink water between the meals. Either you drink water before the before the meal, that is 4 hours before or 2 hours before, you drink the water and eat the food. Or after eating the food, that also 2 hours after eating the food, you must drink the water. In between, should not drink water, because it will not help the food to digest. Because in the water, when you drink the water and the food goes, the food simply floats there. It doesn't digest. So you should not drink water in between the food. Some children eat too many sweets, cakes and ice creams. Another thing, that many of us like sweet things, and too much of eating sweet thing is not good, because the teeth get problem. Teeth will go and health will go down. So we should not eat too much of sweets and ice creams. Little enough, if you have taken today ice cream, then wait for another 3-4 days, then you have ice cream. Or if you have eaten chocolate in the afternoon, then you take it tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Don't eat regularly every now and then. As much now, daddy has brought 5 chocolates and you have to finish all the 5. Why? Because otherwise your brother or sister will take it. No, should keep it, and or otherwise share it. No, that is a good habit. And finally, we should also develop nice table manners. We should have some good table manners. If you do not have table manners, it is very, very bad. What happens? Many children, when they eat at the table, they make noise with the plates. When they are eating with the spoon, tuck, 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 they make sound. Second thing, when they eat, they make sound from the mouth. they you know make a lot of noise. Sometimes people while eating they talk or laugh. So what happens, whatever they have, they eat, it comes out of their mouth, you know, it's kind of spitting it. So it is not a good habit. While you, when you eat at the table, sit quietly, eat little, don't fill the mouth, eat little and close your mouth and chew the food like this, not, don't show the teeth and eat, okay, just close your mouth and eat slowly, don't make noise while eating things, and don't take the things for yourself, give for others, wait for others and ask, please can you pass, could you pass, please pass me the rice. No, these are the courtesy words that we must understand. So I hope you might have understood the chapter, that how much important this chapter is, healthy eating habits. No, you should develop it as you go through the chapter. Okay, dear friends, thank you. Stay home, stay safe, have a nice day.